Problem number three, add or subtract the radical expression. We have the square root of 8 plus the square root of 18 plus the square root of 32. As you may notice that these radicals are not like radicals. We have an 8, 18, and 32, so we are not able to just add them. Before we add them, we have to see if we can simplify each one of them individually. So let's start with the square root of 8. 8 has two factors where one of them is a perfect square root. So we're going to separate 8 into its perfect square root and its non-perfect square root. So the factors of 8 would be 4, which is the perfect, and then times 2. Also, 18, we can separate 18 into its perfect square root and its non-perfect square root. We would have 9, which is its perfect, and 2. And then 32, we can also split into its perfect and non-perfect square root, and we would have 16 as its perfect times 2. Okay, now we are ready to take the square roots of its perfects. Let me just mark them here. The perfect would be 4, 9, and 16. So taking the square root of 4, we get 2 with the square root of 2, plus taking the square root of 9 is 3 with the square root of 2, and then plus taking the square root of 16, which is 4, and the square root of 2. Now, as you can tell, we have the same radicals for all three terms and the same index, which is 2, for all three terms. So we can add the coefficients in front of the radicals to find the solution. So 2 plus 3 plus 4 is 9 with the radical of 2. The radical stays the same. That was the reason why we needed the same radicand for all three terms. So the answer for this problem is 9 with the radical of 2.